Welcome to all for the session of ducts in air conditioning. Students, we will discuss this session or this topic in four modules. Module 1 deals with introduction to ducts, some basic facts about ducts we will deal with module 1. Then in module 2, we will see what are the various pressures were acting when air is flowing through the ducts, and then how to find the pressure loss due to the friction and some dynamic pressure loss in module 2. Module 3A, we will see the equivalence between two sections, particularly for rectangular ducts and for circular ducts. And in module 3B, we will deal with numerical aspects about the equivalence. In module 4A, we will focus on what are the various methods used for designing the ducts, and in module 4B, we will again deal with some numerical aspects. So students, we will start with module 1, introduction to ducts. So the learning outcome of module 1, students should able to know. So this is a Bloom's level 1 remembering aspect. So students should able to know what is duct, what are the chief requirements, yeah, we can say objectives of duct, then on what parameters ducts classification is done, and which material is used for the ducts. So we will start with what is duct. So duct is nothing but it is a pipe or passage used in heating, ventilation and air conditioning to deliver and remove the air. Means from air conditioning equipments, the conditioned air is given to the space which is to be conditioned, and the recirculated air should be removed from the that space and again supply to the air conditioning equipments. So basically duct is a pipe or passage which deliver and remove the air. So these ducts are basically classified into 3 or 4 types only, but again ducts is classified on the basis of pressure also and velocity also. So we will deal this one by one. So what is supply air duct? So obviously it will supply the design air, or we can say condition air, from AC equipment to the space which is to be conditioned. Then return air duct, it will carries the RC air, recirculating air, from the conditioned space back to the AC equipments. Fresh air duct, it will carry the OD air. OD air means outside air, that is called as atmospheric air. This air will be supplied to AC equipment for further processing. Then ducts are again classified on the basis of pressure. So student, remember, in ducts pressure is always expressed in mm of water column, or we can say in centimeter of water column. So on that basis, when the static pressure of air flowing inside the duct is equal to or less than 5 cm of water, it is referred as low pressure duct. When it is more than 5 cm and less than 15 cm of water, it is referred as medium pressure duct. While when this static pressure is more than 15 cm, it is referred as high pressure duct. On the basis of velocity of air flowing through the duct, if the velocity of air flowing through the duct is up to 600 meter per minute or less than 600 meter per minute, such ducts are called as low velocity duct, and when it is more than 600 meter per minute, such ducts are called as high velocity ducts. Then we will see what are the objectives of an air conditioning duct system. So basically the condition condition air which is to be supplied to the condition space with the help of ducts. So these are three objectives of the duct system. The every duct should convey the correct amount of air flow to the prescribed location. Then duct should be economical in both initial cost and operating cost also. And while delivering the conditioned air from AC equipment to the conditioned space, it should not generate or transmit any type of objectionable noise. That's why the design of duct is very, very important. Then generally we will classify the duct system on the basis of loads acting on the duct. When air flows through the duct, some load is exerted by that air due to the pressure and some turbulence. But when we go from application to application, like residences, for commercial systems, for industrial system, the classification of duct varies. But commonly, we can classify the ducts according to the pressure and velocity also. So when we discussed in previous slide, when pressure is less than 5 cm and velocity of air flowing through the duct is also less than or equal to 10 m/s, such ducts are called as low pressure ducts or low velocity ducts. When velocity of air is less than or equal to 10 m/s, but static pressure is more than 5 cm but less than 15 cm of water, it is referred as medium pressure systems. And when velocity is greater than 10 m/s and static pressure is again greater than 15 but less than 25 cm of water, such duct system is referred as high pressure systems. Then we will see the velocity aspect. What happens if velocity is more than 10 m/s? So high velocities in the ducts result into these three things. When velocity of air flowing through the duct is high, it means duct size is smaller, means lower initial cost and space requirement. But due to high velocity, the pressure drop when air flows through the duct is much higher, means to overcome this pressure drop, a larger fan power is required. And obviously, when the velocity is high, noise level is also high. So these are some recommended velocities for certain applications are given. For residences, 3 to 5 m/s air velocity through the duct is preferable. Yeah, most suitable for theaters where large pupils are gathering there. So velocity may be equal to 6.5 m/s or in some cases it is 7 m/s. And in the restaurants also it is more than 7.5 or and equal to 10 m/s. These are some recommended velocities by the refrigeration engineers. Remember, for designing some main ducts, and obviously the main duct is branched into the number of ducts to reach up to from the AC equipments to the certain desired condition space, some branches are also required. So if data about velocity of air is not available to you, then for designing the main duct, you can take the velocity of air from 5 to 8 m/s. And for branches ducts, you can go for 4 to 6 m/s. Obviously, the main duct is important, which is fitted near to the air conditioning equipments. So, velocity of air flowing through the main duct should be higher than these branch ducts. And for ships and aircrafts, the space requirement is very important. So, allowable air velocities is nearly equal to 30 m/s. These are some recommended velocities. Then second classification is according to the shape of the duct. So commonly four type of shape of ducts are commonly preferred. First one is a round ducts, that is called as circular ducts, then rectangular ducts, square ducts and oval shaped ducts. So if you focus on these figures, this is a larger side A and this is a smaller side B. So this is a rectangular duct. All sides are same for square duct. This is having one diameter, so this is circular duct, and this is having some oval shape. So this is called as oval duct. And if we compare from economic point of view, and if we focus on all these four figures, so with respect to economic point of view, see, circular ducts are more preferred since this circular shape carries more air in a less space as compared to these other ducts. Also, circular ducts needs a very less insulation material, and again less friction, less surface and less material is also required as compared to other ducts. If we consider this shape of ducts with respect to appearance point of view, the rectangular duct is commonly preferred because it is very easy to work with in relation to finished surface of a room or a space. So commonly if you observe the residential room or any space or commercial room or space also, so appearance or aesthetic point of view, it is very easy to go with rectangular ducts. And from practical point of view, square ducts are commonly used because it requires a very minimum sheet metal, and again with respect to room or finished surface of room or space, as compared to rectangular ducts, square ducts are also more flexible. Then we will go which type of materials are used for ducts. So generally galvanized iron sheet metals are used for the ducts, and this is the standard and most commonly used in fabrication. What are the advantage of galvanized iron sheet? Because of zinc coating, it prevents the rusting and avoids the cost of painting. Again, GI sheet might rust over a days, giving rise to a bacterial growth. This is a drawback of GI sheets. When conditioned air flows through the ducts, that air is a combination of dry air and water vapor. So what happens after over of days, due to that presence of moisture, some bacterial growth is produced, and that is very dangerous when such GI sheet ducts are used in hospitals and ICU rooms. But it is commonly preferred in residence because not much concern, as normal human being has adequate resistance to bacteria. So remember, in residential aspect, GI sheets can be used, but when ducts are used in certain vulnerable conditions, like in hospitals, then instead of GI sheets, go for aluminium sheets. So, what is the advantage of aluminium sheet again? Aluminium ducts are used due to its lightweight and again resistance to moisture. This is the main advantage. That's why it is commonly used in hospitals, particularly in operation theater and intensive care units, since patient is in more vulnerable conditions to bacteria because aluminium is a very rust proof. But it is most economical and super flushes in normal conditions. Nowadays some non-metal ducts are also used. Some wooden ducts may be used in places where moisture content in the air is not very large, then low cost wooden ducts can be preferable. Cement asbestos ducts are also used for underground air distribution, and also for exhausting the corrosive materials. And some glass fiber ducts can be used due to their strength and easy manufacturability due to the desired shape and size also. But remember friends, commercially the rectangular or square duct shape of duct is rectangular or square, and generally galvanized iron sheet is commonly preferred. But remember, in hospitals aluminum sheets are preferred. So this is the end of module 1, some introduction to basic. So this is the exercise for you. When you go through this video, you will find all questions, answers of these questions. In next module we will go with various pressures in ducts, then what is continuity equation, application of Bernoulli's equation, loss of pressure due to friction, then dynamic pressure law, and some numerical aspect also. For any further query, you can contact me on this mail ID, or you can go through my blog. This is the link for blog. Thank you, students.